Casey.
Hi, I'm Lauren.
Hi, I'm Stevie. Hi, I'm Tim.
Hi, I'm Felly.
And together, we're High Five!
Hi. You know, I'd really like to get a pet. I'd like a pet puppy dog, but I know it's a lot of hard work, so I'm doing some planning first. Now, I've made a chart of all the things I'd need for my pet puppy. Now, first up, dogs need plenty of drinking water, and I'm sure I've got a bowl here I can use.
Meow!
Was that a cat meowing? Anyway, I've got one bowl for a puppy dog. Now, all I need to do is add some water.
Chop, chop, meow, meow.
Is that meowing again? Milk? Hey, what's going on here? I don't need milk. That's for pussycats, not for puppy dogs. They need water. Puppy dogs and pussycats, I know which I prefer. I like the ones that woof and bark, not the ones that purr. Pussycats are very nice, they make such lovely pets. But I like the ones that woof and bark, cause I like dogs the best. Oh, next up, I need a bouncy ball. Dogs love to chase them. And I'm sure I've got a bouncy ball here somewhere.
Squeak, squeak!
One bouncy ball for a puppy dog to play with. What a mess! Oh, is that a mouse? Oh, whew. It's only a toy. A cat toy. Puppy dogs and pussy cats, I know which I prefer. I like the ones that woof and bark, not the ones that purr. Pussycats are very nice, they make such lovely pets. But I like the ones that woof and bark, cause I like dogs the best. Water for drinking? Check. A bouncy ball for playing? Check. Now the final thing I need is somewhere for my puppy to sleep.
Pussycat, meow!
There, a cushion. A puppy can sleep on that. A cat bed? Hey, what's going on? I wonder why all these things keep turning up today. I know. I could put the cushion in the cat bed and I'll grab the ball and the bowl of water too. There. Got everything. Except the puppy or even a pussycat. Well, I've got everything a cuddly pet needs.
Chop, chop, pussycat. Meow.
Having a cat nap. Big stretch. Ah, feels good. I'm a kitty cat, a kitty cat. I spend my days having cat naps. I stretch and preen, and when I'm done, I purr. I warm myself in the sun. You know what this means. Kitty cat fun. I'm a kitty cat, a kitty cat. I slink about and pounce like that. Dangle some wool, the game has begun. I like to play and have kitty cat fun. Oh, game over. Time for another cat nap. What a perfect life.
Tim the pet cat bed here, and I've got a busy waiting room full of animals to see. So come on. Whoa, what a racket. Settle down, everyone. Settle down. Oh, that's not working. Maybe if I sing a nice soothing song, that might calm everyone down a bit. I'll give it a go. If I play a soft song, you might sing along. It might make you feel alright. Come on and sing it with me, soft and quietly, and then you will feel alright.
Meow.
That's better. Now, how can I help each of you? I can't hear you when you all call at once. I think I need some more calming music. If I play a soft song, you might sing along. It might make you feel alright. Then sing it with me, soft and quietly, and then you might feel alright. Here we go. Now a chicken goes, and a puppy goes, and a kitten goes. Come on and sing it with me, soft and quietly, and then you might feel all right. That's better. You know, I can do my job a lot better when you're quiet, don't you know?
Hey, Pet Vet Tim.
Yeah?
Can you sing that song again?
Sure. Here we go. If I play a soft song, you might sing along. It might make you feel all right. Come on and sing it with me, soft and quietly, and then you might feel all right. Here we go, guys. Now a chicken goes, and a puppy goes, and a kitten goes.
Meow, meow, meow.
Come on and sing it with me, soft and quietly, and then you might feel all right. Now, who's first to see Pet Vet Tim?
Whoa!
Whoa! No! This is it. Well, it is a nice day to be walking, that's for sure.
Hey, guys, look, it's Stevie!
Hey, guys! What are you doing?
Well, we're going for a walk.
A walk? Well, can I join, or should I say, can we join?
We?
Yeah, well, going for a walk is fun, but walking a dog is even better.
Oh, yeah. But where do we find a dog?
Well, leave that to me, guys. Come on, Scruffy, over here. That's it, boy.
Time for another Fitbit tip.
Okay, now Scruffy here is going to give us the heads up, or should I say tails up, on another Fitbit tip, aren't you, Scruffy? Now, when you meet a dog, you don't just go bundling up to it and give it a pat. First, you must ask the owner for permission. Tim, would you like to demonstrate?
Okay, okay. Excuse me, sir, but is your dog friendly?
Why, yes, he is, aren't you, Scruffy?
You big furball, you. Yes.
And can I please pat your dog?
Oh, well, yes, you can, but here's the Fitbit tip, and you must remember this. Patting the chest is best. That way, Scruffy can see your hand and he'll trust you.
I get it, sir. Okay. Patting the chest is best.
Yeah, that's it. Okay, guys, who wants to pat Scruffy? Come on in.
Come on in, guys. Come over, pat. Come
now, pat his chest. That's it.
Pat under here.
Yeah, good pats, guys.
Good dog, Scruffy.
High five!
Make sure you have plenty of water, Jumpy. You too, Waddle.
Woohoo! Oh, hey, Chats. Chats, what are you doing?
Oh, hi, Case. I'm just giving my coconuts a drink. You have to look after your pets, you know.
Pets? Wait, so you're telling me that these coconuts here are your pets?
Yep. This is Jumpy.
Oh, hey, Jumpy. Nice to meet you.
That's Rolly.
Rolly? Oh, hey, how's it going?
Spinny.
Spinny? Oh, you're pretty cute, Spinny.
And Waddle.
Hey, Waddle. Hey, that sounds like fun. Well, nice to meet you, pet coconuts. Chats, can they hear me?
Oh, sure they can, Casey. If you know how to talk coconut.
Talk coconut, hey?
It might seem strange, it might seem silly, but talking to a coconut is really hard.
if you're not a coconut. But if I can do what coconuts do, well, maybe that's like talking to.
Oh, well, hey, Jumpy, how you going? Hey, Jumpy, look, I'm jumping, Jumpy. Woohoo!
Jumpy's a bit tired today. Why don't you talk to Rolly?
Oh, okay then. Hey, Rolly, how's it going? Hey, Rolly, watch this. Oh, I'm going to roll forward and I'm rolling back. Hey, Rolly, look how I'm rolling, Rolly. Wah!
Casey, I don't think Rolly can see you rolling around all over the place because she doesn't have a neck. She is a coconut after all.
Yeah. All right, well, how about if I try spinning next? All right. Hey, Spinny, watch this. I'm going to spin this way. Oh, yes, and spin that way. Woohoo!
Casey.
Did Spinny just say something?
Spinny's grumpy today. Spinny's not talking to anybody.
Right. I didn't realize that. This is tough.
It might seem strange, it might seem silly, but talking to a coconut is really hard if you're not a coconut. But if I can do what coconuts do, well, maybe that's like talking to.
Hey, Waddle. Hey, watch this. I like waddling too. I'm a waddling machine. Yeah! Oh, chat, Waddle's not saying anything either. Oh, I just can't seem to get through to these coconuts.
Casey, you know coconuts can't really talk.
Of course coconuts can't really talk.
Oh. I've got a new nickname for you, Floppy.
What? Floppy?
Yep, because flopping down in the chair is what you do best.
Well, Chats, I am feeling pretty floppy after all that action. Hey, Chats, I'm floppy, floppy, floppy.
Oh, good one, floppy.
Hey, guys, I'm floppy.
In today's story, if you watch carefully, you might find a red rake. It's our hidden treasure, and we'll show you where it is at the end of the story. Here we go. It was shearing time at Sheepy Sheep Farm, and all the sheep were getting restless as they waited for Shearer Shauna to show up and shear them.
Sheesh.
Bah! Hurry up already.
Yeah, we're hot under all this wool.
Ah, a bit of patience, please, Curly and Snowy. We'll get started as soon as the new sheepdog's here.
You know, I can't wait for my favourite old haircut.
Yes, exactly the same as last year.
We're sheepy sheep, we like meat. Feeling trimmed is such a treat. Short back and sides, always the same. The sheepy cut is its name. Short.
Short.
And sweet.
Sweet.
For sheepy sheep.
But hang on, who's this arriving? It looks like someone new.
Bah!
Ruff, ruff, ruff.
Who are you?
I'm your new sheepdog.
Oh, you don't look like a sheepdog.
Well, that is because I am a French poodle. You can tell because I have the latest fashionable cut, the poodle too.
Wow, so fluffy.
So stylish. Mm-hmm.
Our old Shearer Shauna only knows how to give us the same old sheepy cut.
Yeah, we want the poodle do too.
How do we get the poodle do?
Well, I know. Right now, just run away and hide.
Good idea!
This way!
Okay.
So when Shearer Shauna showed up, she was a little surprised to see Monique the poodle sitting there.
Hey, we're Curly and Snowy.
And who are you?
Oh, well, I'm your new sheepdog.
You?
Oh, yeah, I thought I'd give it a go.
Oh, well, the first thing you got to do is round up the sheep.
Oh, right. I didn't realise. Okay, then. Well, I will go and,
Round them up.
Oh, right. Okay. Rope!
I think you might need some help.
Oh, hey!
When I want to be sure!
But we need your wool!
Come back, please!
But Snowy and Curly were not coming back. Yet.
and neither Monique nor Shearer Shauna could catch them.
Hey, you guys love being Sean. What's all this about?
Well, we want a different type of wool cut.
Something more up to date.
More fashionable.
Yeah, like her. But I only know how to cut one way. I can't do a poodle do cut.
You know, I might be able to help.
So later that day, they all trooped off to Monique's poodle do salon.
Just a little more fluff and puff, just like this.
Oh, thanks, Monique. Great poodle do tip.
Ooh, my new pom-pom is very different.
And mine is so very different too.
We're poodle sheep. We like sweet. Feeling groomed is such a treat. Fluffed and puffed, never the same. For poodle do is its name.
Stylish.
Stylish.
And sweet.
Sweet. For poodle sheep.
And so Shearer Shauna changed the name of the farm to Poodle Sheep Farm. And they all lived happily ever after. So, did you spot the red rake? Yep, there it is. Well done. Okay, guys, let's trim up another song.
Yay!